Good morning, everyone. Hope you all are good. This is Nilanjana Behra, your art teacher, and today we will be doing tints, stones, and shades. When we add white to any color, it's called tint. When we add black to any color, it's called shade. And when we add gray, it's called tones. So these are the things that we will be studying today. Now the question is, will it always be the same tint when I'm adding white to any base color? It's no. As I increase the ratio of the white, it will definitely create a lighter tint. And if the ratio of the color is more, then it will be a darker tint. So we have to just keep that in control, that how much lighter we want it. And according to that, we will be adding and increasing the level of white to it. You all can create your own color palette like this, where you can mix tone and shades and create a different or separate section for each cool and warm colors, or you can go with the primary or secondary colors. Now for today's work, we need these basic materials. With the help of ruler, I have created these boxes where I have divided into 9 equal portions, and I have created 3 blocks where in the first one I will be using white, second is black, and third one is gray. So the first block which I am doing, it is directly the bottle color, and on the same palette section I will be increasing the white. So when you're gonna apply that second shade, the second tint, just try out at the once, just make a small stroke on that section just to check whether the color is a little lighter or not, and then slowly you can proceed. As it will have water in it, so it may appear a little darker, but once the water evaporates, it will come in its original tint. While creating this tint, there will be a time when you may add the white a little larger in quantity. Just don't worry at that time, just try to add back that red and just try to balance out, and do check it just applying by a single stroke on the section. So there will be a time, like sometimes the ratio of the white may we take it in larger in quantity because we are using the same brush, so nothing to worry, just add back the previous color and try to manage and check the shade whether it's correct or not. So as we are going towards that last 3 or 4 sections, so now we have to increase the quantity of white because we need to create it little different. There may be like 2-3 blocks, they look similar. So we have to maintain that each time it's quite lighter. And even the last blocks, you can directly take the white and take a little amount of red, or just the same brush, you can mix it and create it. Now I'm starting with the second one, which is the shade, where we have to apply and mix black. Each time when I'm mixing black to the red, it will be very tiny amount or very small in that quantity. See how much I have used. The first shade, just after the pure red, will be a very lightest difference will be there, and slowly it will move towards the maroon tone and then the brown. So make sure when you're using black, you can use a smaller brush, maybe 0 number or 1 number. Slowly it will appear like a burnt sienna and then burnt umber also. One thing that you have to maintain is gradually it will move towards the darkest tone. As previously we have done with the tints, they all appear to be lighter because we are increasing the quantity of white. And in the second one, when we are creating shade, then we have increased the same black amount, so it also appear towards the last one is more with that black tone. The last one is adding gray to the base color. In the first block, I am using the pure red. Now here I am using red and using the tip of the brush to take gray. So in the first section it will be less in quantity. And as we are moving towards the right side of the sheet, so we will increase the gray portion there. And even we can try out by creating a stroke in the same block. The last 2 to 3 blocks, they appear to be little bit similar. So now the larger amount of gray is being added to it, and see how different they all look when we have this tint, tone and shades. Hope you have understood how to do this and will definitely try. Even with different colors you can try. Maybe you can take all the cool colors together and then just try out this palette, or the warm colors. But you do have to try this, because the next work that we will be doing, it will be based on these tints, tones and shades only. Thank you for watching the video.